Okay, let's make some mock-up wheels for this 52. I'm gonna go with a 26 inch, I think, is what I'm gonna go for on these. 26 inch wheel. Fit the wheel well real nice. Should be able to, that way I'll be able to air it completely out. The tires won't hit the inner fenders. I might be able to go with a 27, but this will help us determine that. So I made this simple plywood jig for my Milwaukee router. Got 13 inches from the center pin to the inside of this router bit. I'll screw it down to this piece of 3/4 plywood and cut it out. Use rigid foam insulation to put underneath things that I cut, whether I'm using the router or jigsaw or skill saw, especially on plywood where most of my workbenches are covered in crap, so I can't use those, so I just throw it on concrete. Perfect 26 inch circle. At least it should be. 26 inches. Now, get some Super 77, glue the template onto the center, and I'll drill my bolt. This template has 4.5, 5 on 4.5, 4 3/4, 5 and 5.5. Bolt pattern I'm working with here is 5 on 4.5, so. Go with the red ones here. That's the Ford Explorer bolt pattern. And then the Ford Explorer 8.8 with 373 gears with poly instead of an 01 or Explorer. And the TCI suspension I'm using on the front is 5 on 4.5. This 2.5 inch or 2 3/4 inch pull saw should work for the hub pilot. On the front end of the back, might have sanded it a little bit. But. See if it fits. Looks like the bolts fit, and that hub has a little bit of a step in it, so I'll have to sand that pilot a little bit. Sanded a little even, a little more even than I can eyeball.
All right, there you have it. 26 inch wheel and tire combo up in the fender of a 52 Ford. I'll work in the rear. I'll use them to decide how high to do the step notch on the frame and work on the front. Verify, I'll put that front clip back on there and verify that I have enough clearance. And mostly just for suspension travel more than anything.